up to meet my sir. Do you want to join us on stage? Ladies and gentlemen, you will see on your tables in front of you a copy of the declaration that the Honorable Minister of Tourism of Jamaica spoke about, and you will also see the main points coming up on the screen itself. We're going to have a very brief signing ceremony. The tables are about to move. Cue table.
Ladies and gentlemen, in Jamaica, we had the good fortune of having the name by and a number of other major partners in the tourism industry present with us. And my friend Najib spoke for all of us a while ago, but I needed to add that Jamaica spoke in tangible form at the conference as the award ceremony that was held for the icons of tourism of the Caribbean, when we honored Dr. Dalim Rifai for his invaluable contribution to the development of tourism in the world. And I want to convey that to this closing meeting.
Mohammed Al-Khalifa, President of the Bahrain. Milan, which it lies on very important subject, sustainable tourism. I'm very proud and honored to be one of the ambassadors for sustainable tourism for development. And I hope we can give our country what we support. I believe that we have gone beyond the need of raising awareness of the importance of tourism sector as a vital economic driver. Thanks to the great effort of the World Tourism Organization in this area under the leadership of His Excellency Dr. Khaled Barufai, who support all of us. Many thanks again, Dr. Khaled. Now it's time to focus on transforming the vision of the organization into a reality in order to align our achievement with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. It's clear that our investment in renewable sector is the right decision to consider, excuse my pronunciation, a right decision to consider, especially when it's continuing to prove to be the ideal alternative for the energy sector. You know, with the glasses, I can read well, so I think without it, it might be much easier. Ladies and gentlemen, from cultural perspective, tourism outputs are not only limited to the financial gains. It's contributed to creating culture enrichment and exchange knowledge among individuals with different demographic and ethnographic backgrounds. It's also given us the opportunity to experience different cultures, the heritage of people, their story, traditions, art, and music. And I think we all believe that the music and art is a human language, and we can reach everybody without any translation. And most importantly, to recognize aspect and interact with others, which will eventually create a state of peace, one that we all need nowadays. I think we need it very much, especially in our part of the world, in our region. Ladies and gentlemen, we live in a conflict torn world in which wars continue to destroy everything that is pure and beautiful, as I said, especially in our part of the world. Today, we must unite our views and effort to preserve our national wealth of a human heritage and protect the legacy of ancient civilization has left on our land. I think it's our mission to protect the historical site and the World Heritage site and to continue working for peace and beautiful world. Many thanks again, and I'm more than happy to continue being an ambassador for sustainable tourism. Many thanks to Dr. Khaled Barufai and to all of you. And I hope to see you one day in Bahrain. Bahrain is a small country, rich in culture, and I hope I will receive all of you one day in my country, Bahrain. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Excellency, and thank you for joining us in this journey. It is now my pleasure to announce the second Tourism SD Ambassador. It is His Excellency, the President of Costa Rica, Luis Guillermo. On his behalf, we have the pleasure of having with us Minister Mauricio Medina. Thank you.
friends, friends of tourism. Con el paso de los años, Costa Rica se ha consolidado en materia turística con una clara visión. Somos un país que ha adoptado la sostenibilidad como una forma de vida. Para ello ha sido fundamental desarrollarla en sus tres ejes fundamentales: sociocultural, ambiental y económico. Durante este año, de forma inédita, la Asamblea General de Naciones Unidas declaró el año 2017 como año internacional de turismo sostenible para el desarrollo. En Costa Rica nos retamos como país para aprovechar ese momento histórico y reposicionarnos en el mapa turístico mundial, lo que nos ha permitido vivir una época sin precedentes para la industria turística. Por ello, en el marco de esta ceremonia de clausura, quien fue designado embajador especial, agradecemos el constante apoyo y la sinergia que hemos logrado con la Organización Mundial del Turismo. Y a corporaciones propias de su cargo, al señor presidente, le fue imposible asistir a este importante evento. Desde Costa Rica nos envían el siguiente mensaje.
Señor presidente, around the world, we have seen a rapid shift towards a more inclusive and green development. Even as this trend poses some challenges, it may bring some opportunities to the tourist industry. We celebrated 2017 as designated by the United Nations General Assembly as the International Year of Sustainable Tourism for Development, which demonstrates that the economic, social, cultural, and environmental benefits of tourism are greater if it's carried out hand in hand with sustainability and inclusiveness. Costa Rica has had a well-established sustainable tourism policy for over 30 years. This model strongly focuses on the conservation of natural resources and biodiversity, as well as the inclusion of people as the main shareholders of such conservations. The key of our success, therefore, has been linking conservation with the social, cultural, and economic well-being of communities. Thanks to this approach, an outstanding ecotourism industry boomed in the country many years ago and has ever since exponentially grown, generating thousands of jobs and foreign exchange earnings. The application of the Social Progress Index to touristic facilities has proven the positive impact that sustainable tourism has for innovative and inclusive economic growth, employment, and human development. Promoting entrepreneurship, local business, and empowering communities to participate in decision-making processes is crucial and seeks constant cooperation of government and civil society organizations, the private sector, and municipal governments to keep making tourism work and grow sustainable. As special ambassador in the Dominican Republic, representing the countries of the Americas in 2017, I'd like to thank the valuable efforts identified in promoting tourism as an important driver of social and economic development. Mr. Polulikashvili, I wish you all the best in your new responsibility as leader of this organization. Please rest assured that you and the UNWTO will find in Costa Rica an ally in all efforts to promote sustainable, green, and inclusive tourism in line with the sustainable development goals of the United Nations. I wish you well. Thank you very much.
take this opportunity to send further messages. I don't want to just say words of them. I spoke about the Global Smart Tourism Center we are going to, and we are working on establishing. This board will have, this center will have a hydrogen board, to which I would like your permission to invite the distinguished ambassadors to become the founding members of the high-level advisory board. We need you to continue your role indefinitely on this board. Number two, this board will have a board of directors, the center, of international agencies specialized in smart tourism. And we already started this morning working on, I set up a working group that will select the major and leading international and private sector organizations. Then we'll also have a network of members, which will include all the tourism community as membership of this center. I heard a lot of many speakers mention the private sector. I come from the private sector, and I want to claim that the private sector has one definition. It is, he is the creator of knowledge and wealth. Private sector, not government, is the creator of knowledge and wealth. Next, private sector is the future in everything that we do. Four major knowledge companies in the world are competing by the year 2020. Who will reach first the 1 trillion worth? 1 trillion. The value of these four knowledge companies, each of them is 1 trillion. I don't know how many states in this world have a GDP or wealth of, or net worth of 1 trillion. Very few countries in the world. We already have four companies that are becoming the world leader. Already the largest trader in the world is not a company in oil or in real estate or in banking. It is Google, which is a knowledge company. Having said that, I would like to say that I applaud your statement, Ms. Zorita Yuservi, because I serve on one of my current positions at the UN, is as member of the High Level Advisory Board of UNDP on social impact. Social impact. I want to applaud UNDP because UNDP has taken the decision not only to focus on development, but to focus on development for social impact. It's not enough to have growth in GDP. It's not enough to have the other economic indicators. We are now developing social indicators, social impact indicators, so that we know which development, which economic policy is helping the people. This we will also take into consideration in our project in the Smart Tourism Center. We need to think social impact and not just economic impact. Of course, you are taking that into consideration in your thoughts about providing employment, etc. But what we're talking about is the overall indicators for social impact of any economic or any business activity. As I said earlier, I beg my senior members, and I'm the most junior of you, the senior ambassadors, to have a small meeting after the statement by the Secretary General, the closing remarks, to just try to plan our future work. Thank you very much, and I'm very honored to stand here in front of all of you, and particularly in front of you, my great friend, Dr. Talib Rebar. Thank you.
Thank you, Your Excellency, for your inspiration. I would like now to call for the designation as Special Ambassador for Tourism and Sustainable Development Goals, the Chairman of China Union Bank, Mr. Good.
Dear Secretary General, we have Mr. Vice, the Chelsea, Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to be continued as special ambassador for the sustainable development of the forest. Through the discussion, especially in the so many speakers and panel discussions, we should say that 2017 sustainable development for the tourism development is very successful. Look forward, UNWTO suggests that next 2 years, especially 2018, set up another 17 development goals. It is also have a lot of work to do for us as a special ambassador. I should thank all of you for your support. Our payment legal development business around the world. At the same time, I should say we need to do more work to serve, to support the tourism industry development. Take this opportunity, I just want to say a few words about safe and stable environment for the travelers. I think safe and stable social environment is the precondition of the sustainable development of the forest industry. Creating a safe and stable environment for tourism is the common responsibility of society as a whole, and it is essential for facilitating sustainable development of tourism. Therefore, I would like to stress a point of the 4 points. First, a strong condemnation of terrorism. In recent years, some resources and entertainment were targeted by the terrorists. In the regions that suffered from the terrorist attacks, various indicators of tourism industry saw tragic tumbles soon after. For example, after 9/11, terrorist attacks in the U.S., the number of tourists heading to the Americas, Middle East, and Africa declined significantly. So we think every industry, especially related to the tourism industry, need to provide a safer and stable environment for all of the travelers. Second, the creation of a safer and sound environment and infrastructure for travel, such as transportation, telecommunication, dining, loading, and payment. Governments and the tourism authority, the private and the public sector, should work jointly together in enhancing efforts to be made to ensure the safe and operations of the public transportation in tracks such as buses, ferry boats, and cable cars, and provide the public housing incidents, such as food poisoning or outbreak of infectious disease. From my perspective of a payment industry, our company is primarily engaging in the rapid development of the card payments and the card-based mobile payments. Secure and convenient payment service always are a priority. It should be a critical driving force for the sustainable force of tourism. Thirdly, better emergency response to the travel accidents. On one hand, it needs to be done to continuously improve tourist infrastructure, then enforce safety checks, identify potential risks and make timely corrections to mitigate potential safety hazards. On the other hand, the emergency response system should be put into place, which will allow tourist authority to carry out quickly and openly and attack issues in case of any emergency. Fourth, a mechanism for reputation combat. Travel safety issues are serious as they take a heavy toll on the market and undermine the tourist commissions. Destination is the history of such incidents with the improvements of safety proportions should build an effective travel, a safety reputation, combat mechanism. Such a mechanism should include the safety information exchange, tourism safety promotion and presentation, tourism safety quality inspection, demonstration of good travel experience, etc., so as to regain trust and bring a local tourism to a full recovery. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, tourism industry as a great example of globalization has become a significant bridge for people from different countries to enhance communication and mutual trust. Those who dwell in the pools of global economy, we shall spare no efforts in promoting a harmonious and safe environment for travel. Work together and continue to the sustainable development of tourism industry so that the tourism can have the best travel experience. Thank you very much.
Also, priority change. In my capacity as
just finished a study what the priorities of today customers are. And this was mentioned before, safety is number one. Safety is number one, and there's a ranking of destinations. And it's very important for us to make people smile means not only make the customer smile, but also makes the people in the destination smile. And there is where it comes exactly to our SDGs. We as the private sector fully support these SDGs to protect our natural resources, to protect Mother Earth for future generations, but also clearly, I think, to protect our own business. And this is my message. These are not opposite targets. This is a common target here. And we have to fight together for the common goals. And I'm proud that in my capacity, drive forward the way I think you started. Thank you for the close cooperation and for the friendship for many years now. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Frenzel. Thank you, and please join me in a round of applause.